Stock sector winners from 2018. That's what we're talking about today. My name's Jeff Beers. This is 40 Finance. Let's jump in. So the inspiration for the stock sector breakdown came from a website I follow, ETF.com, where Sumit Roy took a look at the top 10 performing sectors based on ETF valuations throughout the year. And I thought he did a really nice job, and so I'm sharing the results here. So if you haven't been to ETF.com, it's sort of a quasi-membership site. They do have a lot of free content as far as articles, breakdowns like these, and you can get some basic information on ETFs, including the scores they give for each one of the ETFs available on the market. So let's take a look at what Sumit had to say. At the top of the sectors for 2018 was healthcare. So as Sumit says here, of the 11 sectors, 5 of them are up and 6 of them are down on a year-to-year basis. So across the board, there's 11 sectors in the stock market. There's actually some changes this year because the telecom category got turned into like communication services category or something to better fit the needs of like Google stock, Facebook, etc. You can read more about it, but if you trade in telecom sector ETFs, which hopefully not too many people do, then you likely experience some changes in the holdings for those ETFs. So you can look it up on your own, but there is still 11 sectors. And of the 11 sectors in 2018, healthcare landed at number one, and it returned 12.2%. as measured by the Vanguard Healthcare ETF. So that's the way that Sumit and I subscribe to this as well. That's the way he's looking at these sectors. It's a lot easier to just take an ETF that follows each sector in order to kind of gauge the performance for the year. So healthcare at number one, and he puts the healthcare sector has outperformed over the past few months as investor concerns over the political situation appear to have eased, allowing them to focus on the attractive characteristics of the sector. I know that drug stocks in particular seem to be on a roll right now, so that's one to look into. And regardless of the economy, it's pretty safe to say that health, hospitals, drugs, etc. are still all going to be in need, particularly as the population grows and the population gets older. So expect to see more of this in 2019. Following closely behind healthcare is the only other sector to deliver double-digit returns, and that is utilities. So here, Sumit quoted, the Vanguard Utilities ETF, ticker symbol VPU, rose 11.5% to date as investors sought out defensive sectors to hide out in amid 2018's volatility. I think you're going to see a lot more of this over the next 12 months as well, as people shift to quote unquote safer stocks that don't necessarily have high growth portfolios, but they do. Typically, utilities pay dividends. Typically, they're very stable. I don't know how the oil prices going down as far as they have will affect utilities, but that's something to watch before you dive into here. Also, how do things like electric cars, green energy in general, will this impact the utility sector over the long term? I don't follow the sector very closely, but those are just some ideas that you might want to read into. Heading into the number three best performing sector, the headline's a little ominous. Tech falls back down to earth, but as Sumit says here, the group went from almost a 25% return at its highs to an 8.7% return currently. And that number might have even changed over the past 24 hours because of all the dips we've seen in the stock market. Regardless, it's still a positive return. It is still right up there with utilities and healthcare. And from my boat, that's very important because I'm heavily into the tech sector, and it basically is the foundation for all of my investing, whether it is consumer technology, platforms that are built to enhance consumer sales, even internet-related stocks that power consumer behavior. Those are all things that I'm interested in. That's where I've put the lion's share of my money. So it's good to see that despite the dip at the end of the year, technology still came out positive. On the similar grounds, consumer discretionary was also up high, 17% earlier in the year, and now it's trading about 2.9% year-to-date gain. So I'm also big on consumer discretionary, particularly in places that it connects with technology. And you see the top holdings like Amazon, Home Depot, and Nike are all well off their highs for the year. However, I think the changing landscape in technology will continue to keep those stocks higher. And consumer spending in general, even if we had a recession, it's going to affect things more like car purchases, house purchases, etc. I don't really see it impacting like Home Depot, Amazon, and Nike. Not that they won't, not that their growth won't scale back, but I just don't see those purchases going away, particularly with low unemployment and pretty good wage growth. I think consumer discretionary will continue to at least keep its head above water in turbulent times. So lastly, Summit looks at everything else that was down for the year. Basically, you know, like he said, we had five up and we had six down. The ones that are deep in the red for 2018, industrials, financials, energy, communication services, which that's the bridge between telecom over to communication services I talked about. That sector is sort of missing a definition in 2018, so you can almost ignore that. But regardless, it's not like telecom grew in 2018. I don't think anyone expected that. And then lastly, materials are all down 10% or more year to date. So that gives you a little bit of an idea of who won this year, who lost. I think at the end of the day, the takeaway from this sector study is if you are in the winners, then while you may have lost money at different points, depending on where you invested during the year, you fared much better than the laggards. Who, you know, so folks that were entirely into industrials, financials, and energy are suffering big. Guys like me who are in tech, consumer discretionary, it's not that it was the biggest celebration in 2018, but gains were made. Losses were also had too, because if you came in prior to, say, October, then you paid a different price than what we're seeing today. So all in all, understanding which sectors are going up and which sectors are going down is a great way to look at the stock market before investing. So hopefully this was helpful. My name's Jeff Beers. This is 40 Finance. We'll see you on the next video.